In this video, we'll be going over common problems that can happen when setting up PyVision to be accessed from a new DNS name. Three of the common problems are an internal server error when selecting databases in the AF hierarchy, or nothing will be shown here, and a 401 internal server error when trying to access PyVision through the new DNS name. Now, to start troubleshooting, we want to check what the PyVision logs are saying. All PyVision messages are written to the Windows Event Viewer log. PyVision messages are written to the application log, and for this type of accessing issue, it is going to be written to the OSIsoft search folder. And from there, inside that, we have the admin. And to see the more details of the error, we want to enable the debug log. To do that, we'll go View, Show Analytic and Debug Logs, and then click Enable. Once it is enabled, we'll generate the error again and it will populate the log. As you can see, we are getting an SSL error. And this is because when configuring PyVision to be accessed from a DNS name, it needs to be a domain signed or a third-party certificate and not a self-signed certificate. You can see we are using a self-signed certificate from this error here. You will have to talk to your IT team and ask them to generate a certificate for you to use. This certificate will need to have in the subject alternative names and entry for all aliases, including the new DNS name you wish to access PyVision from. There'll be a link below for more information about the certificates. Once you have the certificate, you'll need to change it in the PyWeb API admin utility tool. From here, since all this should be pre-filled in, you will have to hit next until the certificate section. You will then select change and change the certificate to your new one. As you can see, the subject alternative names are filled in, including the new DNS name, which for mine is PyVision. We then select next until the submit URL section. Here we see that it is set to the machine name and not the new DNS name. For now, we'll leave this as is and finish running through the configuration. After that is completed, you'll have to perform an IS reset to apply the certificate. We could then navigate to PyVision and see that the certificate error is gone, but we still get an internal server error. From here, we go back to our event viewer, into the message logs, and now we see another error, which is just the internal server error. Since we are still seeing the internal server error, we need to check to see if our PyVision configuration file matches the URL in the PyAdmin utility tool we saw before. To find the file, we go to where we installed PyVision, and on my test system, it is in C drive. From here, we go into PyPC, PyVision, and then open up the web config file. Here, we look for the search service URL, and as you can see, someone has set this to the new DNS instance name. Since these do not match, we need to go back into the Py admin utility and change the URL to match our config file. We just have to make sure the configuration file matches the utility. We can just change the configuration file URL, but I want the search service URL to be the new DNS name. So now we'll go back through and change that. Now that we have matched the two URLs, we need to see if the spins have been set for the new DNS name. The spin should be set for the service account or machine account that is running the PyWeb API, crawler, and application pool services. To check if the spins exist, we open command prompt and then type the following commands. Set SVN-L, and then you want the domain followed by the service account name or machine name. And I forgot to put a space after the dash. As you can see, we have the HTTP spins for the Web 1 server, but not for our DNS name. So now we need to set them. So set SBN-A, which will check for duplicates before creating the service HTTP, followed by our DNS name, followed by the domain and service account. So we do this for the host name and the fully qualified domain name. We can then check to make sure the spins do in fact exist. And as you can see, they're right there. It is not case sensitive either. So now once these are set, you wait about 5 to 10 minutes and then check back on PyVision to check your new DNS name and everything should be working there.